mesh analysis or loop current method, or it is also known as Maxwell's loop equations. In this method, it is assumed that each loop of the network has its own current. The equations are formed for each loop by applying KVL. Solving these equations simultaneously, one can calculate loop current and current in any branch. First, draw this figure. What is the statement of this mesh analysis? In this method, it is assumed that each loop of the network has its own current. But here we have the three loops, 1, 2, 3. Theoretically, not actually. What is the assumption here? Theoretically, we are assuming that each loop has its own current. Now, first loop has its own current, which is I1, maybe. Second loop has its own current, which is I2. And third loop has its own current, which is I3. This is assumption, not the actual. Because this is not the practical calculation. This is theoretical calculation. What is the assumption in this method? Assumption in this method is that we are assuming each loop of the network current. Means number of loops is equal to the number of loop current should be there. Is it right? Now, what is the next part of this statement? Equations are prepared for these loops by applying KVL to each loop. Now, how many equations we will get from this? Three equations. We have the three equations, and how many unknowns? Three. We can solve those equations simultaneously, and we are in a position to calculate the values of the currents I1, I2 and I3. And if we know the currents I1, I2 and I3, then we can calculate current in any branch. Suppose the current in R4 is asked. As per this assumption, this I3 is flowing downward, this I3 is flowing upward. I2 minus I3 or I3 minus I2 will be the resultant current in that particular branch. We can calculate that. When it will be positive, when it will be negative, we will discuss at the time of the solving the sums based on this, because here I don't want to introduce that particular concept here. So here, if we want to apply the KVL to the loop number 1, loop number 2, loop number 3, what is the standard methodology which we are using? Depending on the assumed direction of the current, mark the terminals for each element in the circuit except EMFs, because terminals of the EMFs are always fixed, which is given by the designer itself. This is plus minus, this is positive terminal, and this is the negative terminal. Means all elements in the network, resistor, maybe capacitor, maybe inductor, maybe combination of all, we have to mark, because the voltage developed across these elements is nothing but PD, which is potential drop. Is it right? Now here, we will mark the terminals depending on the assumed direction of the current, which is clockwise here. Generally, I will assume clockwise. In this resistance, it is horizontal. Means it will be plus minus. This is downward. It is plus minus. There is no other element. Leave it. Now next, only we will consider the I2. We are not considering the I1 here. Based on the I2, it will be plus. This is minus, plus minus. This is plus and minus. If I have taken it, it will be plus minus and reverse. Is it right? Similarly, in this case, this will be plus minus, this is plus and minus. Don't bother about assumption of the direction of the current. It is your choice. But stick to those directions till the completion of the problem. Is it right? Now, if we have taken the clockwise, these will be the marking of the terminals for the loop number 1, for the loop number 2, for the loop number 3. Is it right? If I have taken the reverse, the all terminals will be reversed except these battery terminals, which are always fixed. Battery terminals are never going to change as per the assumption of the direction of the current. Are you getting me? Now, apply the KVL to the loop number 1, loop number 2, loop number 3, prepare the equations, and then we are able to conclude something here. First, assume the direction of the current, mark the terminals in your figure, and make a habit. Always before applying the KVL, you are going to mark the terminal. It will avoid lot of confusion and errors in the calculations. Make a habit, assume the direction of the current, mark the terminals, apply the KVL. From the first point, applying KVL to loop 1, we get. If we are applying the KVL and I am starting from this point, I am moving in the clockwise direction. Negative to positive, which is a plus. What is the voltage of this element? V1. Then positive to negative, which is minus, its potential will be its current into its resistance, which is I1 into R1. Then we are traveling from positive to negative, which is minus. Its resistance is R2, but this is a common branch for the two loops. Is it right? In that case, I1 is a downward, I2 is upward, means resultant current must be I1 minus I2, or maybe I2 minus I1. If I am following the sign conventions of the I1, I have to take it as I1 minus I2. If I am following the sign conventions of the I2, I have to take the reverse, I2 minus I1. But generally, for the loop 1, we are assuming the sign conventions of the I1. For loop 2, we are following the sign conventions of the I2. You see, here in this case, V1 minus I1 into R1 minus R2 into I1 minus I2, which is equal to 0. This is the equation number 1. Simplify it and name it as equation number 1. If we are simplifying it, it is V1 minus it is I1 into R1, then minus it is I1 into R2, minus of minus plus it is I2 into R2, which is equal to 0. Is it right? If we are separating the terms, then it is V1, otherwise I will shift the V1 to the next side. That is minus I1, if we are taking as a common, then it is R1 plus R2, then plus it is I2 into R2, which is equal to minus V1. This is equation number 1. Apply the KVL to the loop number 2 and start from this point. Travel in the clockwise, maybe in the anticlockwise direction. Here, if I am traveling in the clockwise direction, positive to negative, which is minus. Here, it is minus. Its resistance is R2. I am following the sign conventions of I2. That's why resultant current will be I2 minus I1. This is I2 minus I1. Then we are traveling clockwise, positive to negative, which is minus. Its current is I2, its resistance is R3, that is I2 into R3 will be potential across this element. We are coming down, positive to negative, which is minus. Its resistance is R4 into its current. It is I2 minus I3, because we are following the sign conventions of I2, it will be I2 minus I3, which is equal to 0, because after that there is no element in the circuit. Simplify this equation. It will be minus it is I2 into R2 plus it is I1 into R2 minus it is I2 into R3 minus it is I2 into it is R4 plus it is I3 into R4, which is equal to 0. If we are separating the terms, I guess it will be something like this. It is I1 into R2 minus I2 is a common, then R2 plus R3 plus it is R4, then plus it is I3 into R4, which is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Again, for third loop, I will start from this point. I will travel in clockwise direction. Positive to negative, which is minus. Its resistance is R4. Current is I3 minus I2, correct. Then positive to negative, which is minus I3 into R5, then plus, sorry, minus V2. Positive to negative, minus V2, and then no element in the circuit, which is, then its simplification will be I3 into R4 minus of minus plus it is I2 into R4, then minus it is I3 into R5 minus V2, which is equal to 0, means final equation will be minus, sorry, plus I2 into R4, then minus I3 is a common, then it will be R4 plus R5, which is equal to V2. This is the third equation. Solving above three equations simultaneously, we are able to calculate current in any branch.